It's really a great joy and a blessing to be with all of you. And anytime we can gather as disciples of Jesus to pray, it's always a blessing and a grace. So we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord God, we consecrate this day. We consecrate our lives to your service. And we praise and thank you for the gift of life, for the gift of our faith, for the gift of our vocation, which was born in the waters of baptism. And as we reflect on the wonder and power of that baptismal call this morning, we ask that you renew within us this ardent desire to give ourselves to the service of the gospel, for the salvation of humanity, for the liberation of the human person. And bless this conference that it may truly be fruitful, that we may go forth energized, inspired, and ready to re-embrace our vocation. Amen.
The first thing I want to do is to ask a few questions. Why do people join groups and organizations? You know, Knights of Columbus, CWL. What is it that they're looking for? Or what is it that they expect to get from it, that they hope to find? Maybe whom do they expect or hope to encounter or to find? Maybe it's a someone, not just something that they want to get. The charism of St. Vincent, I think, allows for an openness and an encouragement for all people to be part of this. It doesn't matter what the job, you're invited. It doesn't matter what your position or your relationship in life, whether you're single or you're married, you're invited. We all are called to respond to the charism of St. Vincent Pallotti. In our apostolate, we are all called to bring God's love to others. And I think it's really as simple as that, and yet it's as complex as that. I think in order to bring that love to other, love of God to others, we first have to experience it ourselves. And in my time in the UAC, I have come to know God, this God better, who in Isaiah says, "Because you are precious in my eyes and glorious, and because I love you."
I'd like you to reflect one more time on what do you see in your community that you can do to help others and spread the gospel in the spirit of St. Vincent Pallotti. When Father Joe asked me to consider joining the UAC group while we were forming one, and I said to him, Father Joe, I'm so busy. I think you saw in my presentation, I do a lot. And I said, I can't imagine having time for one more meeting or one more thing. I just don't know where I'm going to find the time. And we talked. We had breakfast, in fact, if I'm not mistaken. We were out to breakfast together. And he turned to me and he said, Linda, you are already living the life of St. Vincent Pallotti. You are already doing his work. We're not asking you to change a thing. We're asking you to now do it in the spirit of St. Vincent Pallotti.
Dorothy Day. I'm a writer and a Catholic. An historian once called me the most significant, interesting, and influential person in the history of American Catholicism. Too much praise makes you feel you must be doing something terribly wrong. Dorothy Day. As a writer, she was prolific. As a Catholic, she was devout. But it wasn't what Dorothy wrote or what she believed that was so extraordinary. It was the fact that what she wrote, what she believed, and how she lived were exactly the same. And God will command the angels concerning you.
Gospel reading today, where our theme came from for this Congress. Jesus summoned the 12 and began to send them out two by two. We heard in Maria's talk yesterday morning about how we are all called to the UAC in different ways. We shared our stories about how we've been called from different walks of life, whether we were aware of what the UAC was or not. Somehow we were called to this community. In the same way, Linda talked about how we were sent out to do service. We were sent out to live the gospel in the world in various ways. She shared her story, and hopefully we shared our own stories at our tables. What an appropriate way to end our time together and send us out with talking about something that's going to be going on worldwide in this next year, in the year of faith, with this emphasis on the new evangelization. So we're going to try to tie that all in together with the charism of St. Vincent Pallotti and kind of what we see as a vision and how we can interpret that as members of the UAC.
Glory to God, and on earth peace to people of good will. adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks.